My name is Millie Rincon-Cortes. I am a PhD, recently graduated from the Sullivan Lab, and we're here at the Child Study Center at the NYU School of Medicine. We study how infant trauma, specifically within the context of the caregiver, programs brain and behavioral development. I'm originally from San Juan, Puerto Rico. I went to college there, had no neuroscience experience there, majored in biology, and I moved to New York City in 2009 to pursue my PhD in neuroscience. So the way that my interest in depression started was actually because I had a pre-existing addiction interest. Addiction is a problem in Puerto Rico, where I'm from. I've known people that have suffered from the disease. Yes, it is a disease. It's also a problem in the States. Addiction and depression are comorbid, so I'm hoping that whatever I can find in our rodent model of trauma and depression, some of it might be transferable to the addiction component. So here at the Child Study Center, we have a cryostat, and we use it to section rat brains into very tiny slices that we can then later stain and see what cells are active in a particular brain area. The cool and time-saving thing about this cryostat is that it actually has a pedal in which you can step on, and it'll make the cutting process much easier. So when you have hundreds of brains to cut and a lot of sections to collect, this makes life way easier. So when I realized that I wanted to go into neuroscience, I was in my senior year in college. So this was definitely not my first plan, but I sort of ended up falling into it, and I've never looked back since.
Perspective, and it literally, you have one of these and it goes zoom, 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 like all the way. Like, but it takes a long time and you need way more slices.
I feel that I'm a good scientist because I can retain the big picture without forgetting about the details. I'm very passionate. This job career has sort of become part of my life and my identity, so it gives me a sense of pride and self-worth, actually, to be able to do this and do it well. On my best days, I run an experiment, I finish running an experiment, and I get to see my data and see if I have an effect. And that to me is hands down the best part of this job, just knowing that you're figuring out whether something is true or not. Can I repeat it, etc. On a bad day, I'm troubleshooting an experiment that doesn't work, and so I have to change one variable at a time to try to figure out why isn't it working.
And this software will allow us to count exactly how many cells were active in a particular brain region in response to a behavioral task.
Science has definitely been a great avenue for meeting new researchers and establishing collaborations that I can hopefully maintain or have contacts that I can take with me as I move up in my career development. What I sincerely hope out of science is to be able to keep doing great work and hopefully find answers that lead me to even more exciting questions. In the big picture, what I hope that my work does is make breakthroughs that can aid in treatments and therapies for patients with depression, addiction disorders, anxiety, etc. So if I can get people to start thinking about development as something that's important to look at, then I would feel satisfied. What I would say to people that are interested in going into an academic research career and starting by grad school is, A, don't get too overwhelmed. You will learn what you need to learn with time. B, be patient. Not everything happens fast in science. And C, just don't give up. Like, you're gonna hear all these things. Why are you doing this? You could be doing this other thing. If you have the passion and you really enjoy it, then it's really not that hard.